Look at that. Like, this was the board just a couple of days ago. Can you see that?
It's a list of every song.
That was a list of every song and everything that needed to be done, filled with crosses. Now look at it. Just like that. An album done. Handed over. I could sum up the last 3 years, which has been the making of this album. I would say that across the board in all of us, there's been like a deepening. From my standpoint, just being that person who's been able to witness people's journeys, to see our team navigate seasons and to come out deeper, deeper in every sense, deeper in emotion, like deeper in the word, and for that to be shown in the songs, I'm really proud of that.
I've actually taught Fat Ken Kenobi everything he knows.
It is a representation of, you know, each and every, you know, one of our relationships with God, and yeah, I think it does feel real earnest.
We might have a verse idea.
Okay.
It's not much.
Yeah, like I'm not sold on it yet.
I'm definitely still not mature. I'm still like, you know, still a kid. Who loves cheeseburgers at 3 a.m.? I think it'd be weird if over the course of 3 years, you know, all of us hadn't grown deeper in our relationship with God. I think that would be almost alarming.
About to record Aidan King singing.
Is that headphones?
Better be good, otherwise we're in trouble.
All right, I'm here.
I thought when I turned 18, I was just like, all right, this is who I'm going to be. But I feel like as every year goes on, you learn more and more and you grow more and more.
I thought the straight was really cool because it's just different.
I've taught green everything I know, really.
We're definitely getting older, less young and free.
Crossing off the first base of the album.
Feels good.
Well, he crossed one thing already.
Yeah.
Wow, that's one out of 16, 17.
Yeah, wow.
I got like none of those TikToks. I still got a bit to do.
This is a continuation of our story. This is chapter 3, and if anything, this is us in devotion with Jesus, which is what it's all about. And I think it's going like, at that point, my heart was tested. Like, at that point, my faith was tested. At that point, my trust was tested. But at the end of the day, I know all that really matters is that you're pressing in to Jesus. Yeah, I think it is a coming of age. I think it's coming into yourself. I think it's growing up. Yeah, it feels like growing up.
For Christ.
Yeah.
Sitting in the back of the bus alone, we're all gonna come and lift him up tonight. It's all for you.
It's all for you.
One sec. I've got to go the right sound.
2, 3, 4. Kiss Christ. Kiss Christ. We're gonna worship him all night. Kiss Christ. Kiss Christ.
Oh,
Karina's complaining because the pop filter smells bad.
I have requirements, you know.
I'm so sorry.
You have the candles going. You know what? I think I'm going to deliver a better vocal performance because of, you know, just the fragrance.
And the people in Young and Free were already leaders in my life. And I kind of just, like, looked to them for advice and in, like, a lot of areas of life, not just music. I was just some kid in youth looking up to these people, like, looking up to Renee and Tracy and Melody. It's funny, I was talking to Ben the other day. I think we realised that we've known each other for, like, 10 years now or something. It's been a really long time. When I was in middle school, I wanted to focus more on music, and Ben ended up being my guitar teacher. The first song that I've ever wrote, I brought it to Ben. It's almost come full circle because now, in this third album, we've written Days Gone By together, and it's like he was my mentor in high school, and now we're at this point where we're sharing ideas and writing together, and yeah, it was kind of cool.
Built up a thousand walls to try and hide away. I searched to find my soul, a journey far from home, lost in the life I'd made. And I'd be running circles.
We had this song almost finished. Like the lyrics, we just needed to get them like over the line, I guess. And then Levi was born, Ben's baby. I think it was the day after they got back from the hospital. I was over at their house holding Levi, and then me and Ben were trying to finish the lyrics to this song.
Before the baby was born, I was like, yeah, this is cool. We've really come a long way from where we were. And then once my kid was born, I was like, oh, this is really cool. Like, I can see how good God's being, like, through the whole process.
When you see God working through everything in your past, seeing how he's shaped together everything, you know, then realizing that he was the one who was orchestrating things, and that's why you need him in your future. Why would you live without that?
The whole idea of like seeing God in hindsight, we're talking about all the time, and I think that's why this album is the growth in the album. We've gone deeper is because we've had time now to reflect and look at all the things that God's done.
Yeah, no, this is great. Wait, Renee.
Dude, I'm a photographer.
It's amazing.
Our bump-in was meant to be 11 a.m. and we are 6 hours behind. Our truck with everything in it is 120 miles away.
We're gonna have to go make an announcement outside.
There's people out there already.
Yeah.
Update us.
It is now 6:40. The truck is still not here, which is crazy.
Do you know what? I've got a strong feeling that tonight's gonna be great.
It is now 7:06 p.m.
Truck's here.
This is the real thing. This is not a drill.
No matter what the season David seemed to be in the Bible, every psalm, everything starts off with an element of praise. It's just like, I'm in the worst season of my life, but I'm gonna praise you. And like, I just think there is some correlation between like God taking you on the journey. It's so that we can know him more, so we can know him better, and hopefully that we can write songs, and what comes from those places is the intimacy that, you know, we can share, hopefully, with other people.
Back in the PC!
Woo! Jim Hortons!
Until your love took over me.
Nice. Can you do the falsetto octave here as well?
I was on the edge of deception, caught up in my own hesitation.
That sounds like a lizard.
I think when you're younger and you haven't been through things, like you can write you know, from a perspective that can maybe just be like, yeah, lovey-dovey, and that's great because that's what's real at the time. But I think as you grow up, you start to realize, like, you know, life can actually be hard and people can go through things. And so let's declare something. Let's use the word of God to, you know, put faith statements in people's mouths. Highs and Lows is this song that we've had for 2 years, and one night we're just like, let's go write. And so we went to this studio, and this was not in the middle of a project or anything. We were just kind of writing, just cause.
It's like 2 a.m., 3 a.m., so we finish the song. The next day we listen back, we're like, oh, wow. No one could ever match whatever was happening that night. It was like so special.
Was toying around with the Psalm 139, and it says, if I climb to the heights or I make my bed in the depth, like, your presence still meets me there. And it's not often that you know in the moment, whether you're at the top of whatever success or excitement or whatever, or you're at the low, in those moments it's hard to sometimes remember, hey, actually God's with me, because you just neglect it. But when you look back, you go, oh wait, hold on, he actually was with me that whole time.
Being a part of the team, you know, you go from this excitement of like singing these songs in front of people, and you feel that and you sense that, and you're delivering these songs from a place where you believe it and it's true, you know. And then you can go home and the lights turn off and it's just you and you're alone and it's there. You can experience lows, you know, and that's been really challenging. What I've realized is that God does await us in every place.
I know there are people who are dealing with things like depression, where they feel like swallowed up by life circumstances. And, you know, my prayer for this song, Highs and Lows, is that it would encourage you to remember God is chasing you down. He'll never leave you, he'll never forsake you. It doesn't matter how far you run. It's hard to sometimes know that, you know, in the moment. But my prayer is that song will do that. Come with wings, or find me far side of the sea. People need battle cries about God. People need confessions about who Jesus is. And for us, like, the reason why I do all of this is because I want to see those friends come back to God. I want to see those friends reclaim their first love, go back to that moment where they were saved. Highs and lows, Lord, you're with me, the way it goes. Should I rise or should I fall? Even so, Lord, your mercy is an even flow. Should I rise or should I fall? You are faithful through it all. You're too good to let me go.
It's the So Will I guy. It's the So Will I guy.
Do you know what I feel like? I feel like Highs and Lows is such a moment and the theme that's going to resonate with so many people. You want to be like really strategic about what that goes into.
I think you either put it out towards the front of the album or as at the back.
You know, I like to think that for whatever reason, God has gathered us, like this group of people together. And I often wonder why. Could be anybody. Why us? Why me? Here's people who are just like on the journey, you know, and at the end of the day I've watched people like make a conscious decision like to allow Jesus to be the one that sustains them, you know.
We're about to go on. This is it.
In the Old Testament, they would build altars where God had been faithful to them. And then, you know, when the next person was walking by, like, they'd be like, oh, that's so cool. This is where God answered this person's prayer. And I think this album 3 is just like another altar on the journey where God answered prayer, where God gave us songs, where God gave us revelation to actually show others, hey, this is what God did here.
Basically what I do here, command space bar, record, get the credit.
Can you turn the click on?
I actually don't know how to do that.
So we had like sent, we've done 5 reviews, basically.
And when
4
was
or 5 on all of them.
And when was it meant to go in? To be sent off?
So we're running a day behind. It's just cutting into like the mastering time, so less window time.
Yeah.
If the people only knew, the people only knew that we sent all of our songs off to master today, and now just the voice has decided that he wants to have a say. They only knew that stuff, you know. In Just Jesus, he's like, I can't understand one word. You only need to look inward for 3 seconds or outward for 3 seconds to see problems or complexities. And so for me to go, okay, but what does Jesus say? And he says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Like, it's as clear as that. It's as clear as day. When things get hazy or confusing or whatever, like, no, this is the truth that I believe and that I stand on. And that brings freedom.
It's meant to just be like a vibe. It's meant to be fun and full of life and just like dance and kind of a celebration of Jesus, obviously.
The first time I heard it, I just had this overwhelming feeling to break it down. Hopefully other people have that same reaction.
I can look around and I can see gift and talent, and I can see measure, and I can see like the pressure to be cool, like all that sort of stuff. And then I remember the one thing that I've got is the one thing that I need. And that's relationship with Jesus, and that's to worship Him. That's what I was created to do. The way, the truth, the life. In the journey of making this album, I get excited by like the themes, and I get excited by what we're saying and what we get to proclaim out of our personal journeys, because I know that it's those revelations that resonate with others. So we have these songs, they're in our hand. They have been in our hand for a while now, and we've done our best with them. But my prayer is that they would go into the depths of your soul and engage with your spirit person. That's the difference between just a song and what we do. Like, we create praise and we create worship so that our spirit person engages with something that is so much greater than ourselves.
I just pray that the personal stuff and the journey that God's taken all of us on, the songs are much bigger than our circumstances, but they're glorifying to Him and drawing people closer to Him.
I just think the biggest thing is that the songs would help people, even people who don't know God. When they hear it, that something would click for them and that they'd have that moment where it's kind of like, there's something more than just living for myself.
I feel like everybody can associate themselves with these songs. And hopefully the songs put some of the words in your mouth, you know. If you haven't, you don't know what to say, I hope that this album gives you words to express your love for God. So that's what my prayer is for this album.